Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. pot la même voie. Non.
All right.
It's one for you and one covers us both. On a lot of things you get a euro or 2 euros off the entry fee.
Yeah.
But that nice place, the 45 little town village you've been to, is only open on Tuesdays.
Ah.
So you might actually go in there.
Well, why don't we do that tomorrow then?
Yeah, well, we could do
that. Make
yeah
more sense, wouldn't it? I mean,
I've got the whole day tomorrow. In part of it, okay, tour, but...
Yeah. No, it'd probably be worth going for the full thing, wouldn't it?
Well, I
don't
think
you
so.
I mean, it's when we've got the whole of tomorrow anyway.
Yes, yeah. You know, you don't want to do anything tomorrow, do you?
No, that's right.
Yeah, we'll do it tomorrow. And there's two of the places. She told us to go to one particular place. That's quite near there. We can go there today.
Yeah.
Another one.
Was it in Guyac, the Museum of Wine or whatever?
I think so, yeah.
I think it was Guyac, because that would be worth a look as well.
Yes, it would, yes.
That would be quite interesting.
Yeah.
Swim past loads of vineyards this morning, because I've been up into the hills this morning. Oh, it's lovely out there. I think it is the Pyrenees you can see in the distance, because they're a hell of a long way away, because I was riding along and I was thinking, is that a solid blank bank of cloud on the horizon?
Can't tell, can you?
No, and I thought, that can't be, because you've actually got some peaks on it, and there's, you know, they're wrong shape for clouds. And it's huge. It was right along the horizon, you know, from sort of 120 degrees of the horizon. So whatever it is, it's a huge range. And so I reckon it is the Pyrenees.
Yeah.
So I mean, they're obviously a hell of a long way away, but I suppose they're so high that they actually take out the curvature of the earth, don't they? So incredible. But God, it's absolutely beautiful.
Yeah, we thought looking at the map and the places that, because in that area there's three or four interesting little places to see. There's one with a little train, I'm not sure go on that.
Right, yeah, that's the train itself, isn't it?
But it's quite near.
Yeah. That really was absolutely stunning. That was better than yesterday. And there's, you know, there's still nothing on the roads. It's just, I mean, you get into Guyac and there's a bit, but still not much. I mean, nothing like House of the Sudbury. Nothing remotely like House of the Sudbury. And,
it's a much larger sort of open area here.
Well, like I said yesterday, the thing that amazes me almost more than anything is I still case now, there is nothing new. There's nowhere where you see a modern housing development. Absolutely nothing.
No.
No ordinary houses, no ordinary semi-detached houses, there's just nothing. No. Everything you see looks 100 years old or more.
Really,
you know, the whole lot. Yeah, they're all the same. I mean, there might be some of those that are more recent, but they don't look it, you know, and... that's just when you compare it to our area, that's unbelievable, really, isn't it? No, it's not. It's just quite amazing.
You can see why people like farms. I mean, some people
this part
come
of it,
and buy a little old farmhouse or a villa, don't they?
That's right, that's what Kevin Raymond did, Harold's son.
Did he?
Yeah, he was in there, popped in the
drawing. You can see why they do it,
isn't it? Yeah, you can. Yeah, that's right.
It's a bit like Italy in a way, but perhaps not, I suppose.
Yeah, I've never been to Italy, but this really is just absolutely stunning. I mean, I was just so impressed with that this morning. Oh,
yeah,
16th fastest ever on the climb out of Guyac this morning. It's not bad, is it? No. My first time.
But you see, driving down yesterday, when we drove down the motorway particularly, I mean, it looks slightly nice, but you don't see anything spectacular, really. It doesn't look...
No.
Until you explore in the countryside. Yeah. Doesn't look that, you know, different.
No, that's right. This is just so different to northern France. Something it's just completely different.
Different to England, isn't it? Because you said there was hugely
to see there, wasn't it? No, there wasn't. It was a perfectly nice area, but you know there was nothing special about it at all.
It's just what it was, you know, and. Whereas, you know, really in Denmark, I mean, yeah, much nicer roads than the UK, but then everywhere has. You know, it's a nice clean, that was the striking thing, it was clean. And the thing that was a bit similar is, again, it was almost deserted, you know, compared to our part of the UK. But nothing like this. I mean, a lot of those roads, just running, there was just nothing, you know.